Would you like to talk about the cards?
Alright, so all the festivities are now done with the Zora Duntop Tribute Weekend. So now we're just going to take our general admission tour of the Peterson Museum and see what else they have here. Let's go check out some cards.
Hey, if any of you guys are stressed out that the new C8 does not offer a manual transmission, you can get a manual transmission stress ball. Might keep one of these in my office. Here we have the number 2 1960 Cunningham Corvette that raced at the 1960 24 Hours of Le Mans. Like I said in the previous video, this is not the car that won Le Mans that year. That would be the number 3. But this is one of three, actually one of four cars in existence. Three of them were Cunningham cars, and one has not been restored yet. And here you can see a picture of there are those four cars there at Le Mans in 1960. How cool is that? This thing has been restored to absolute perfection. I mean, this thing is like a Rolex watch. It is absolutely gorgeous. Everything about it. Everything has been meticulously made. These hinges were remade because they were not existing on the car as it was before it was restored. Just look at this glass. I mean, where can you find that? Side pipe exhaust. Original knockoff wheels. There you can see the refueling in the back. Absolutely gorgeous. Here we have the Edelbrock SoCal land speed record car. You guys have probably seen this car in pictures. Really cool to see it in person. It's amazing how small it is and how small the cockpit is. I mean, a lot of people's heads probably can't even fit through that opening. You'd have to be a tiny person to even drive this thing. Really cool though. Piece of American history right here. A front engine dragster. This was before they moved the engine behind the driver's position due to safety concerns. Really cool car. Between these three Ferraris right here, they're probably worth more than half of this museum. And I'm not exaggerating. This car is probably worth close to 30, maybe $40 million. This is the most winning Ferrari GT race car in history. Here is Carroll Shelby's Shelby Cobra. This is one of the real deals. This is the very first production Shelby Cobra, 1962. I believe this car has a 289. This was before they put the big 427 in it. Really cool to see this car here. This car, the paint is absolutely gorgeous. This is the world's fastest coupe. 1934 Ford. Just look at that thing. What a gorgeous car. 1965 Ferrari. This car won the 24 Hours of Le Mans back in its day, making it one of the most collectible Ferraris in existence. This car, really pretty. Another Ferrari. Let's just go over here and appreciate this Porsche. I'm not a huge Porsche fan, but this thing, my God, just appreciate the girth of the wide fenders. That is something crazy. Girth Nation, look at these wide fenders. See, here you can see this is kind of where the stock car bumper kind of finishes. So that is where a standard 911 would end. And there's a good maybe 8 inches of fender flare there. Absolutely incredible. And look at this wing. That is just insane. 1929 Ford Alter Dragster. That's pretty cool. Bruce Myers car. That's gotta be a wild ride. Too Fast, Too Furious. You might recognize this car. One of the many wild imports from the series. Some really cool hot rods over here.
Love that color.
Pretty car. Look at this little push car.
It's an Avery size car.
That's cool. Look at this lead sled here. Holy cow. Love that paint color. Now this is a very interesting. Passenger doesn't get a cockpit apparently. Driver gets a cockpit. Almost like a sidecar in a motorcycle. And that's a really interesting custom car. And it's got a parachute on the back, so it must be fast. Look at all the old Hot Rod magazine covers. Really cool. If you've ever wondered, this is what a Tesla Model S looks like without the body on it. All of the batteries are in the floor, and here you can see the electric motor, front and rear. Pretty cool. Here they kind of have the history of the electric car. Electric cars aren't new. Dating back, let's see, this one is an 1881. Well, this one isn't an 1881, but this one is an 1881. Another electric car here. Of course, here is General Motors' first attempt at an electric car, the EV1. This was actually a real production car, and there's still some of them driving around today. Owners of the EV1 are really proud of their cars. Maybe one day one of these will go up for auction at Barrett Jackson for $1 million. Who knows? Now take a look at this. This is a Nissan R390. This was a homologation special for the early 90s GT1 class. They were required to build a certain number of road cars in order to build a race car to compete at the 24 Hours of Le Mans. So this one, you have the Toyota GT1 as well as several others, but these are very rare cars. They only made a handful of them. I'm not even gonna say how many because I don't know. There's a Maserati SUV, kind of cool. This is a wild looking car. No idea what this is.
It's an Eastern Exotic.
Whatever that is. Acura NSX. Cool to see that here. This is kind of cool. They have some interactive assembly line stuff here. Cool stuff for the kids. And over here, they got some more stuff for the kids. They have a couple of cars from Disney's Cars. This is Cruise. And you got Lightning McQueen over here. And of course in here, you got the Cars Mechanical Institute, where kids can learn all about how cars work. Here's how an engine works. You got different things over here. You can make NASCAR keychains. You got gears. Got some Lego stuff here. You can design your own cars here. You got a little racetrack over here. Look at this. You can color on these interactive touch screens here. And you got some racetracks over here for the kids can build their own Lego cars and race them down the racetrack. Really cool.
See, Lightning McQueen has blue eyes just like you.
What do you think, Avery? It's Lightning McQueen. Ka-chow. This apparently is that car from the Fast and the Furious movies that they jumped out of the skyscraper. I'm not sure exactly what it's called, but I'm sure you guys watching can Google it. Porsche 918 Spyder Hybrid. Really cool car. And here they have kind of a design center where they actually do have automotive design students that come in here and work on different designs. Model cars. Fun fact, when I was younger, I wanted to be an automotive design person, and I almost went to that college.
But if you plans check out changed. The previous video, you'll see our tour of the Museum, and we got to walk through here because they have it usually open on the. Must have been a weekday we came.
Moon rover or Mars rover. Really cool stuff. Bike.
Is this the first car ever?
First practical car. And this is where all of our obsessions started. Bugatti. This thing looks like it's straight out of the Great Gatsby. Harley Earl's Firebird concept. Look at that. This is like a new car made to look like an old car.
It is.
Batman motorcycle. And here is the hall of movie cars.
The Catmobile?
Black Beauty. Death Race 2000. We got Kit from Knight Rider. Not sure what that is. Here we got the flathead 32 Ford from Iron Man. Magnum PI's Ferrari. Here's the Jag XKR from the James Bond movie. And here we got the Gotham Police Department from The Dark Knight. Here we got a GT40. This is an original GT40 Mark III. Mm-hmm. This thing looks like half sport bike and half scooter. Interesting. Now that is a big wing. Look at the size of this Rolls Royce. Massive.
Now when they call cars boats, this literally is like the size of a boat.
Look at these windows. That's interesting. Here you have the Star Wars speeder. It's pretty cool. And here you have the exploded view of an Audi R8. Check this out. That is pretty cool. Oop. That must be really interesting to try to build something like this. And by I mean build something like this, I mean this exploded view model. That's pretty cool. We have this Audi concept car here with this center driving position. And here we have the Iron Man suit.
Spoiler warning, and if you haven't seen Endgame yet, then what are you doing with your life?
Back to the Future DeLorean. Pretty cool. Then over here we have Flynn's from Tron. We have the Tron Legacy light cycle here. Look at that. That's cool.
Well, that's from California. You haven't seen it.
Here's the light cycle Rider movie.
There's one from Black Panther.
Yeah, right there. That's pretty cool. We should watch that movie. I like it.
That's pretty wild. Look at that. This car has a massive greenhouse. Super low to the ground. I think this is Luke Skywalker's speeder from the Star Wars movies. From A New Hope, 1977. Wow, that's cool. Except you don't see the tires in the Star Wars movies. Look at this thing. Wow.
You remember what this is from, don't you?
I remember this movie. I thought this was one of the dumbest movies I've ever seen. But this car is pretty wild. Speaking of mid-engine Corvettes, this is the Cadillac CN. GM made this concept car for the 100th anniversary of General Motors, and again, with the rumors, we thought a mid-engine Corvette might be coming, but nothing ever came of this car. Really cool to see this in person, though. I've never seen it in person. Got a little active aero spoiler. That's pretty wild. Coming back over here to the Death Race. Some of the concept art from the movie. That's wild.
Mad Max.
I'm sorry, Mad Max, not Death Race.
You're getting confused in your movies.
About the same. whatever. They're trying to kill people and they're driving cars.
The only things that don't make any sense.
Who remembers this?
Which is the front and which is the back? What do you think?
Yeah. What's the front and what's the back?
If there was no mirror there, you wouldn't know.
Minority Report. And what do we have here? It's another Lexus concept. Lexus made quite a few concept cars for Minority Report.
What was it from?
Minority Report.
Oh, I was just thinking it was
there's a police car from Blade Runner. 1982. Here's the Audi, kind of futuristic Audi R8 concept that they used in iRobot with Will Smith. And over here we have the Terminator. T-800. I think this is another car from Minority Report. Here we have a cool helicopter. Not sure what movie that's from. What's that from?
AI. Artificial intelligence.
Oh, okay.
It's an amphicopter.
Amphibious helicopter. Interesting.
That's pretty cool.
Well, that is wild. It'd be a cool job to make all of these custom cars for movies. Some memorabilia from different movies. Men in Black.
Another movie I much did not see.
That's pretty cool. A lot of you guys that play video games might recognize this. This is the Warthog from Halo. This thing is massive in person. You really don't realize how big it is in the video game. This thing is huge. Oh my god. That's pretty cool though. This is the Joker Mobile from 1966 Batman. And of course, the OG Batmobile. And then the Tim Burton Batmobile. This is the car that I grew up with. This thing is massive. That doesn't look like a car. Oh, but there are seats in it. Look at that. Wow. Okay. Maybe in 100 years, we'll be driving around something like this. Who knows? Okay, so we started out with a Lamborghini Countach, and then ended up with something like this. All right.
Now it is
this appears to be something kind of like a Hummer.
supposed to, these are supposed to be low resolution vehicles.
Low res.
Low res. That's what resolution means.
I know that's what it means. But use the artist.
Low res. Okay.
Which also means not aerodynamically.
Low res.
Snowmobile.
Low res. All right.
I think it's a snowmobile.
Do it for this weekend here at the Peterson Automotive Museum. As you can see, the C8 mid-engine Corvette behind me here. Stunning car. I'm blown away. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you guys think of this week's vlogs here at the Peterson Automotive Museum. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. Leave a like. Smash that like button. Really helps me. Helps the channel. And until next time, see you guys later. Take care.